In the 1990s, the Chinese government loosened regulations on the housing market. Its 1.2 billion citizens could own private homes for the first time since the Communist Revolution in 1949. Real estate boomed, and demand for all things construction and home improvement boomed with it. Foreign companies like Sweden's IKEA and the UK's B&Q rushed to meet the need. America's do-it-yourself king, Home Depot, followed in 2006 by acquiring Homeway, a Chinese home improvement retailer with 12 stores in 6 cities. But in 2012, when the percentage of homes owned privately in China had reached 80%, Home Depot closed the last of its big box stores and departed the country. With its billions of citizens, rising middle class, and booming housing market, China seemed an easy success for Home Depot. So why did the company's China project collapse? The short story of Home Depot's failure is this. Everything that worked for American consumers did not work for their Chinese counterparts.
They failed in China because they did not understand Chinese culture, Chinese business environment, Chinese people's lifestyle, and more importantly, Chinese people's mentality toward manual labor.
Let's take a closer look. First, the locations of Home Depot's stores did little to entice potential customers. Most of Home Depot's stores were in the suburbs, which in the US is where people tend to move when they gain wealth. But in China, wealthier citizens tend to move to city centers.
That's where the money is, and major corporations need to have presence in the downtown, not in suburb.
Secondly, both the products and the prices did not comport with Chinese consumer needs. As mentioned, China's rising middle class moved to city centers. Their homes were apartments or condominiums, smaller than America's sprawling suburban mansions, with less space to store lawnmowers or power drills. And if they did check out a Home Depot, Chinese consumers found the prices too expensive and rigid. The new middle class preferred to shop around for the best deals and bargain for even better ones in store.
Majority of the stuff that Home Depot sells are made in China, and the same kind of products are available in this kind of smaller stores ready for negotiation. Very hard to go to Home Depot and pay much higher price, no negotiation, and poor customer service, and far away from the city. It takes 1.5 hours just to get to Home Depot, another 1.5 hours to come back.
But perhaps the most important factor in Home Depot's failure in China is this.
Here in the US, I think, you know, doing it yourself is considered honorable. It's considered, oh, you're quite capable, you can do it yourself. But there in China, if someone do it themselves, people, first impression is you cannot afford to hire someone to do it for you.
Professor Gao noted that in China, upward mobility through education, getting away from manual labor, is a strongly held ideal. Furthermore, many of the homes purchased by Chinese consumers in the decade after the government legalized private homeownership were little more than concrete shells. They needed quite a bit of work to become homes, but not work that was easily done by amateurs. It's one thing to DIY a new shelf. It's entirely another to install floors, light fixtures, and plumbing.
So they want to renovate it all at once, and they want very high standard, they want 5-star hotel standard, so there's no way the homeowner themselves were gonna do it.
Finally, China has a large pool of cheap, easily accessible construction labor. Combine that with the anti-DIY bias and major home renovations needed, and it's clear why Chinese consumers shunned Home Depot's method and instead embraced DIFM, do it for me. One notable DIY company has managed to crack Chinese consumer tastes. Sweden's IKEA, which famously asks customers to build their own furniture, still has a presence in China 20 years after initially launching there. As of 2017, China was one of IKEA's top 5 markets based on sales. Professor Gao told CNBC that many Chinese consumers aspire to Western-style home furnishings. So IKEA's convenient model rooms taught eager consumers how to furnish their new homes for relatively cheap prices. From 2006 to their departure in 2012, Home Depot didn't open a single new store. They steadily closed the original 12 they purchased from Homeway. The company doesn't break out sales information by country, but a Euromonitor representative gave CNBC sales data in China for 2009 to 2011. These numbers are adjusted for inflation, and they show that China accounted for barely 0.3% of Home Depot's total net sales. But Home Depot has hardly suffered for their failure to break into the Chinese home improvement market. sales leapt to a record $108 billion in 2018, up from $74.8 billion in 2012, the year the company left China. The company declined to comment for this piece, but a representative did point CNBC to the 2017 Investors Conference for more information. Right now, Home Depot is focused on developing its pro service offerings and expanding in Canada and Mexico, the only countries other than the US where the company has any stores. But if they do ever try to break into China again, Professor Gao has some advice.
Any companies who are going abroad, they need to pay attention to consumer mentality, consumer lifestyle, business environment, and culture. As I say to my students, do your homework. And I would say that to multinational corporations as well.